Good morning and welcome to my channel. This video is on our skeletal system, a science lesson for class 5. The lesson is based on CBSE syllabus. If you are a new viewer, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for educational video updates. Now let us get into the lesson. Our body is made up of various organs like heart, stomach, lungs, legs, hands, and many more. Each organ of our body performs some specific functions. All the organs coordinate well and work like a wonderful machine to keep the body alive. Bones and muscles work together like a team with efficiency and well coordination. They help in the movement of the body parts. Organ system: a group of organs that together perform the same function make an organ system. For example, digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, and many more. The skeleton or the skeletal system. The human skeleton is a framework of bones. An adult human body has 206 bones of different shapes and sizes. The human skeleton consists of a skull, a backbone, a rib cage, and two pairs of limbs. The two pairs of limbs, that is, the forelimbs and the hind limbs, are attached to two pairs of girdles, namely the shoulder girdle and the hip girdle. The skull. The skull is made of 22 bones. 8 bones are flat, interlocked, and enclose the delicate brain inside it. 14 bones are in the facial region. Only 2 facial bones are movable and enable us to talk and eat. The backbone or the spine. Skull is attached to the backbone, which forms the main axis of the skeleton. The backbone is made up of 33 small bones called the vertebrae, which form the strong vertebral column. The rib cage. The rib cage consists of 12 pairs of bow-shaped ribs, which form the rib cage and enclose the heart and lungs. Ribs are delicate, curve-shaped bones which are joined to the backbone and the breastbone. The lowest 2 pairs of ribs are joined only to the backbone, and these are called the floating ribs. The forelimbs are joined to the spine with the help of shoulder girdles, which consist of a pair of shoulder blades and a pair of collar bones. The hind limbs are made of the strong thigh bone called the femur, which bears the weight of the whole body. Femur is the longest bone of the body. The femur fits into the hip girdle with a ball and socket joint and is connected to the lower leg at the knee joint. The long bones of the skeleton are hollow and are filled with a soft, fatty substance called the bone marrow. This bone marrow produces the blood cells. Functions of the skeleton. The skeleton gives shape, support, and strength to the body. It protects the delicate internal organs. The skull covers the delicate brain. Eyeballs rest inside the eye sockets. Backbone protects the spinal cord. The rib cage protects the heart and lungs, and the urinary bladder lies inside the hip girdles. Muscles are attached to the bones and help in the movement of the body and the body parts. The enamel coating on the teeth is the hardest substance in the body. Joints. A joint is the meeting point of two bones together by strong tissues called ligaments. There are many joints in our body. All the joints except the joints in the skull are movable. The bones in the skull are interlocked, making the joints immovable. Types of joints. There are two types of joints in the body, movable joints and immovable joints. Movable joints. The joints that can move are called movable joints. The bones at the joints move smoothly because of a fluid that acts like lubricant. There are four types of movable joints in our body. The types of movable joints. The four types of movable joints in our body are hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint, and gliding joint. Hinge joint. The joints that are like a hinge in the door are called hinge joints. The hinge joint can move the bones in only one direction. The joints in our elbows, knees, fingers, and toes are hinge joints. Ball and socket joint. The ball and socket joints allow maximum movement. In this type of joint, one bone has a rounded ball-like end while the other bone ends with a socket. In ball and socket joint, the ball fits into the socket and allows maximum movement. The joints at the hip and the shoulder are ball and socket joints. Pivot joint. The pivot joint is found between the skull and the first two vertebrae of the spine. The uppermost vertebra in the neck is called atlas. We can move our head in all the four directions, that is, sideways, upward, and downward, with the help of pivot joint. Gliding joint. Gliding joint allows movement at the wrist and ankle and between two vertebrae of the vertebral column. It allows our back to bend, twist, and turn at each joint. Muscles and movement. The body muscles contract and relax to produce the movement of the body. There are about 650 muscles in our body. Each muscle causes a particular movement. Muscles bend our arms and knees, push food into the digestive canal, allow us to inhale air into our lungs, help us to chew food, and make our heart beat. Muscles are attached to the bones by strong fibers called tendons. These fibers become strong with regular exercise. types of muscles. There are three types of muscles in our body. These are voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles, and cardiac muscles. Voluntary muscles. Muscles that are under our control are called voluntary muscles. We can move the muscles out of our will. For example, the muscles that are attached to the bones are voluntary muscles. Involuntary muscles. Muscles that are not under our control are called involuntary muscles. Involuntary muscles control the actions like the movement of food in the alimentary canal, the flow of blood, and the movement of eye muscles. Cardiac muscles. Muscles that are found only in the heart are called cardiac muscles. These muscles are involuntary in action, but their structure is like voluntary muscles. How do muscles work? Muscles produce movement in the body by pulling on the bones. When the muscles contract, the bones come close to each other. When we bend our knee, one muscle contracts and gets shorter while the other muscle relaxes. When we stretch our leg, the reverse happens. Well-developed muscles give a graceful appearance to the body. To keep the muscles in good shape, we must maintain proper posture while sitting, standing, and walking. Our body is a wonderful machine and works in perfect coordination. We must maintain good health by doing regular exercise and giving rest to it. We must eat a healthy diet and we should avoid eating junk food. Hope you find the lesson useful. Thank you and have a wonderful day.